Hey guys, welcome to What to Watch on 3. I'm Peyton Frotwell.
And I'm Christopher Gates. Thank you for joining us for this Super Bowl action movie slash what we're looking forward to special.
Yeah, if you haven't seen already, we have made a video on our most anticipated superhero movies of 2016.
See it down below.
Yeah, two or three of them were presented in the Super Bowl. Super Bowl was really cool for releasing a little bit sneak peeks of what of some of the movies that are coming out, like some of the ones we're going to be talking about is Captain America, Jason Bourne, Independence Day,
X-Men, like and we also have some honorable mentions that we saw. So let's get down to the one that got us most excited, yeah. I think, of it. It was Captain America, The Civil War.
Yeah, I did not think I was going to get more excited for this movie than I already was, because it's already an amazing franchise. Like, Marvel movies are consistent with being, despite what you think of them, like, getting samey or whatever, they're all consistently good movies.
They are.
Yeah, and then sometimes you'll get a great movie
Captain
America Winter Soldier.
Winter Soldier, yeah. Exactly. And it's, since you brought that up, it's directed by the same guys, Russo Brothers.
Yep,
Russo Brothers. And that's one of the reasons why I'm so excited for it, because Winter Soldier was such a well-done movie in itself.
Yeah.
But this particular, what they showed the Super Bowl, you already saw the trailer, and we're already pumped about that. Like, we're going to see that day one. But the Super Bowl trailer, or the Super Bowl teaser that they released, it just showed just a few more clips, and those few more clips already add
to the leverage. They told us so much.
I think the one of our probably favorite scenes, the one that you've seen the most, is when Iron Man, just
Iron
how excited
Man.
I am about it. He has to watch, in which he has, like, it turns into he's able to get part of his hand into it, and Bucky, the Winter Soldier, goes up to him with a gun and shoots him, and Iron Man stops the bullet
And it's crazy because up until this trailer came out, we didn't really know what the stakes were going to be in this movie. We have two teams. We have Team Captain America. We have Team Iron Man. But we didn't know if they were going to be going for blood or if this was going to be some kind of scrimmage match. Because let's be honest, we know that the Infinity War is coming out.
Yeah.
And it's going to be two movies of just nonstop fighting, and we have to have every character that's in our arsenal to make these two movies. So I would be surprised if there was one death, and even more so if there was more than one.
Yeah.
So I'm definitely seeing with these clips, like the one you mentioned with Bucky shooting at Tony Stark, point blank almost.
Oh my goodness.
That these guys are for blood.
They're
out for blood.
Other scenes that got me is there's the scene where Black Widow's looking over, and it seems like destruction is going on, and she seems like she doesn't know what's going on. And the end clip where they show all of them together, we saw Ant-Man. We see Ant-Man's on the side of Captain America, and he also has with him Hawkeye and Scarlet Witch and Bucky and his friend Falcon. But I think the part that surprised me is who was on Iron Man's side. You have War Machine, but I was surprised to see Black Widow and Vision and Black Panther.
Yeah, because Black Widow, from what we've seen of the last Captain America movie, she's one of the Captain America's best friends.
Yeah, you would think that, but she seems to be on the side of caution, that she thinks that, hey, you know, maybe he's going too far. And even what they're showing right now, that's not the whole movie. We know there's a lot more that's going on.
We still haven't seen Spider-Man.
Thank you.
We haven't seen Spider-Man at all. And I'm hearing good things about Tim Holland. He's the young actor who's playing Spider-Man. I'm hearing really good things about him.
I think, you know what? I think he's gonna make a perfect Spider-Man. And, you know, those who read the Civil War comic book know that Spider-Man is an integral part to this series.
Exactly.
And I'm glad that Marvel was able to get that. And I'll be honest with you, I really do think that this is probably going to be probably one of the best Marvel movies to come out.
It's certainly pointing in that direction.
Yeah.
We can only hope. If it ends up being really good, I'll be impressed that the Russo brothers managed to have this many Marvel franchises in one movie and made it still seem like a Captain
America
movie.
And they are the ones that are going to be directing the Infinity War when that comes out in 2018, 2019.
No more Joss Whedon.
Then again, no more, you know, James Spader, Ultron.
Yeah.
There are no strings attached.
Yeah, love him or hate him, you still got to love James Spader.
Voice. I have nothing against that. Yeah, the voice itself. His voice, along with the Bane voice, are two of my favorite voices to do.
Yeah.
I do horrible jobs with them. But I do the best I can, Peyton.
We try.
We try. The other one that we're really excited about, and I didn't really have any idea, and I forgot it was going to come out, Jason Bourne.
A lot of people did. A lot of people forgot about this movie.
I saw this when I was looking at it. I was like, what is this movie? And then when I finally saw, like, that's Jason Bourne, I almost went into a geek attack. I was like, it's Jason Bourne.
I had my mom and my girlfriend off to the side talking about, I don't know, cooking, whatever women talk about while we talk about movies. And I was just like, guys, Matt Damon is beating people up senselessly on the TV screen. You have to stop talking. And this movie, we finally have a title for this movie. It's called Jason Bourne. Just
that's it.
Yeah.
And I saw we tweeted out actually the film poster, and it says, you know his name, and you do. You know
that's
who he is.
Greatest tagline.
Yeah.
You see Matt Damon doing that, and it's just great.
I mean, the end part of the trailer. There's two things that stood out for me. A, you got Tommy Lee Jones, so I'm already excited about
that. Exactly. You already got a fugitive vibe.
So you already got you already got a lot. Search over hen house and farmhouse. Two, you. I'm terrible at presses. Two, the end part where he just knocks that guy out with one hit.
That's amazing.
He just walks up
very
to him.
Indiana Jones.
Oh yeah, definitely. And you know what? The scale of the adventure, the movie itself looks to be, you know, almost much bigger thing.
Yeah. But Paul Greengrass him and Matt Damon came back for this movie. Paul Greengrass is the guy who directed Bourne Ultimatum and Bourne Supremacy.
Yeah.
I don't think he did the first one. No.
The first one was someone else.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's still from it's the same people. I don't know if this movie is going to be a direct sequel to Legacy. I saw Legacy. Legacy's not bad, but this seems to be more on
Return to Form.
Yeah, Return to Form, the original Matt Damon one. So who knows? Jeremy Renner may make a guest appearance.
So I'm hearing rumors about that. I don't know how much weight I would put behind it.
Yeah.
But it definitely takes place in the same universe because we see characters from both movies in and out. So I'd like to see Jeremy Renner. I don't think it would cheapen the film. I think it would just kind of show a more cohesive universe. Just maybe don't give him a starring role. I wouldn't even give him a supporting role. Maybe mention off camera.
Yeah, you can mention off camera.
Say his name or something.
But this is clearly a Matt Damon, Jason Bourne, you know what you're getting into kind of movie.
You know it's going to have a lot of fights. You know it's going to have a lot of action and a lot of tension.
And a lot of shaky cam.
Yeah,
a lot of shaky. I love that shaky cam.
It's going to be great. Another movie that's going to be great is Independence Day Resurgence. I was excited about this movie because I'm a big fan of the original Independence Day. It came out when I was a baby. I wasn't even watching movies yet. I was still watching Barney.
I don't even remember how. I was probably the same age as you, except I was probably, in third grade, so I was doing math. So,
yeah, we found this movie at a relatively young age, and we still found something to enjoy with it. And of course, as one of the greatest speeches of all time by the president himself, he makes a return in the last trailer. We hear clips of him doing the speech from the original movie, and then it cuts off right before the title. And that was an awesome trailer to get me excited.
That did.
This one got me more excited in terms of seeing just what the aliens have been doing for the past 20 years. The poster that we posted on our Twitter, it says a movie 20 years in the make, or no, wait, we had 20 years to prepare, and so did they. And that just gives this aura of, they're going to destroy some stuff.
Of course.
Jeff Goldblum looking up and going, what goes up must come down, and just skyscrapers falling from the skies.
Oh my goodness.
It's carnage.
I think the part that I really liked that I was watching the trailer is, or the Super Bowl trailer, is when they're doing the national anthem, and you see the fighter jets fly by, and the alien ships are right there and then, and you were just like, if that doesn't get you excited, you need to go to a doctor. There's something wrong with you.
You might be dead. Check your pulse.
You might be. Just saying. But hey, you're dead. You can still view in and still watch the movie.
Thank you for letting us be the last thing you saw.
But no, this movie has a lot of potential to it. 20 years after taking place in real time, it looks very impressive. Like, it's hitting on all the right beats. It has most of the original cast back. The most glaring of them is Will Smith.
Yeah, I wish Will Smith was definitely making a return in this movie.
I think Will Smith would actually, now after seeing it, is like, man, I really should have came back for this movie.
I think he's doing okay with Suicide Squad right now.
He'll be fine. He'll be all right, but still.
He's over there counting his money, going, oh, what? There's a new Independence Day out? I haven't heard of it.
No.
Jeff Goldblum who? I'm so rich.
I'm doing Hancock too. Anyway.
Another movie we wanted to talk about was X-Men Apocalypse.
Yes.
They released another trailer. Not as much new stuff in the X-Men trailer. as we saw in the other ones. We did get a look at Psylocke, played by Olivia Munn, who I am a big fan of from her days of Attack of the Show.
She needs a solo movie.
She needs a solo movie.
She needs a solo movie.
You wouldn't have a problem selling
tickets. Of course
not.
Deadpool can get one. Shoot.
It's like Olivia Munn, barely covered up, and she's slicing cars in half. The tickets sell themselves.
They sell themselves. I don't know why Fox, if you're watching this, go ahead and just
it's great for me because I remember watching GTV, Tech TV, whatever, G4. I think
it was G4. No, yeah, and, you're on the right term.
When she was directing, hosting Attack of the Show. And she was such a cool person, very nice nerd personality, and now seeing her in a superhero movie, it's
she has the Psylocke feel. I'm glad that they actually showed her because it was, we already knew that she was in the movie. We didn't really see her in the last trailer.
Yeah,
but
she was at Comic-Con, I believe.
Yeah. And she's been showing off images of her character, but now you get to see her in action. And she's actually one of the few, I've heard for years now since I've been doing X-Men movies, people are like, where is Psylocke? Like, she's one of the most demanded ones. And, you know, I think they picked, you know, a great actress to play her. Yeah. And to be honest, but in the whole movie itself, I think one of the things that I think this just, and this is showing my age here, because I don't care. It's just seeing the new cast playing Cyclops, Jean Grey, Storm, all of them, and just seeing, you know, not seeing Halle Berry, not seeing Hugh Jackman, James Marsden, all of them playing that, Patrick Stewart, Ian McKellen. It takes a moment.
Yeah.
I enjoy X-Men First Class. I think one of the things that just took me a while, I was like, okay, it's a new group of X-Men. I had to get
it's
used
like
to
Ian
that.
McKellen is Magneto. Patrick Stewart is Professor Xavier.
And, you know, and I've been so used to that for so long. Anna Paquin has Rogue. And, you know, but seeing them coming into it, the one thing that gets me excited, I will say about the Apocalypse, just the whole feel of it, it seems of all the X-Men, really a lot more comic book. Type.
Yeah.
It seems closer to the comic books that I read.
You see a lot more of these superhero movies adapting the more comic type aspects of their respective universes. And I think it's a good time to be a superhero.
It is.
Movie fan or a comic book fan. People like us who grew up on comic books. It's definitely a great time for that. So some of the honorable mentions we wanted to get to was the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle trailer. With Krang.
Krang in it.
Finally got some Krang.
You got to see Krang in Dimension X. And to be honest with you, the whole movie, it's really going closer back to the TV series that we grew up in love.
Exactly.
And it's just set more of a modern time.
Speaking of a more comic book feel, we have a more, it takes a real comic book feel to pull off Krang.
It does. It does. And the set, I give them kudos for it, to be honest with you. This should have been the Turtles movie that came out first.
Exactly.
And I think if this one came out first, I think it wouldn't have been so...
With Michael Bay production instead of direction.
Directing it,
He technically didn't direct the first one either, but it had his fingerprints all
his
over it.
You can tell. When you were watching, you were just like, this is just Transformers. Just
explosions everywhere, and every once in a while there was a turtle.
It's too early. I mean, early analysis for it, for our opinions are still kind of...
We'll see.
But we'll see how it is. But it's doing all the right things. So we're definitely... That's definitely something else.
Another one we want to talk about was 10 Cloverfield Lane.
Oh, my goodness. That's coming out in a few weeks.
Yes. And we hadn't even heard about this movie up until a few weeks ago. That was so impressive to me that nowadays, in the time of social media, that you can keep a movie like this... a sequel to a huge movie that came out a few years back, Cloverfield, so secret. And I had never heard of anything like that. With everything being shared, it's so hard to keep things secret.
If there's one person I would say right now who does an excellent job keeping things secret, that's J.J. Abrams, because no one could have predicted what the Force Awakens storyline was until they went and saw it.
Yeah.
So I give him kudos for this, but that's another one that I think we both will probably go and see.
Oh, definitely.
And we'll definitely watch for a few further episodes for review on that. And
it's okay.
Of course,
words are hard.
There are. There really are. I'm still trying to do it.
And another one we wanted to talk about. Deadpool.
Definitely.
They released a Deadpool 1 as if this movie needed any more marketing. The marketing campaign's been on fire with this movie.
It's been so amazing.
And this movie comes out this Friday, February 12th. We are definitely going to be going to see it. I'm going to see it on Valentine's Day. So
of course.
We'll probably have that review up for you Monday.
And before he even made it, on our last Hellseeds review, which you can also see below if you didn't see it, already teased that we were going to see Deadpool.
Exactly.
And we were going to have a review up pretty soon.
it's definitely, from what I'm hearing, it's getting really good reviews. It's got, I think right now it has an 84% on Rotten Tomatoes.
It's good on Rotten Tomatoes. I read IGN, they gave kudos to Ryan Reynolds' performance. They say he sells the character, he steals the moment.
It turns out loving the movie you're in really pays off when you're a...
I know, right?
You're playing a character.
You know, let that be a lesson to you, further actors out there.
And for some perspective, that 84%, The Revenant, which is being considered for Best Picture right now, only has an 81%.
That's true.
Which is nothing to sniff at. It's just give you a little perspective on... It is a really good movie, apparently.
And that's another thing. All the movies that we mentioned today, the one thing that I've seen, all of them, they have the trend. They are doing a good job trying to market themselves to make them better than, you know, what they really could have been. A lot of these movies could just... And it's too early to tell how they turn out, but a lot of them could just... Threw them out there just be like, eh.
It's February. You don't know what you're going to get. And the marketing is always really good at the beginning of the
year. That's true.
It's more so because usually movies released this time of the year are not that good.
Right.
So they need a lot of good marketing to get people to fill in those seats.
You got to.
But we've actually been surprised with a lot of the movies released earlier this year.
We really enjoy Hail Caesar. Deadpool's looking to be pretty good.
Yeah.
In a few weeks, we'll have 10 Cloverfield Lane. Not too shortly after that, Batman v Superman. We'll see how that is.
We got Pride, Prejudice, and Zombies, which is out now.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
We haven't even seen that one.
We haven't yet.
We gotta get to it. We gotta get on top of it.
We got plenty of time. We got tax refunds, so
there
we'll be
you
rich
go.
For just a little bit.
We're gonna be spending money like our last name's Rockefeller.
We're gonna be spending money like
That's
our last name.
It's a very old joke that I made.
It's okay. It's a great Gatsby joke, and I like that. Not who's there, not Gatsby.
That's a good note to sign off on. We're starting to make Great Gatsby jokes. We need to go.
What are you talking about? Paint? I like Great Gatsby. Quite the same thing.
If you like this video and you want to see more, you can go to WRBL.com, which you're probably watching this on, or you go to our YouTube channel or our Facebook page.
We got a Facebook page now. Look at that. Last time, the carrier pigeon was
able to
make a Facebook page. I'm so proud of the pigeon. I'm not going to say him
that's
or her because I don't know what it is.
That's a reference to our last episode.
If you didn't see it, then you're not into cool just like us. We're really cool.
You follow us on Twitter. You see these reviews and more movie news at WRBL What to Watch. And you can go to our Facebook page, our new Facebook page, and like it at facebook.com. WRBL What to Watch.
WRBL What to Watch.
It's new. I still have to get it.
We're still getting everything in there. We also got the YouTube page set up, and we got everything. So we're going to hit you in every facet of the way that we can, in a good kind of way too.
You know. Thank you guys, and I've been Peyton Fretwell.
And I'm Christopher Gates. Thank you so much for joining in and watching us. I was going to say something smart, but I have nothing smart to say.